Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode here of Final Fantasy 15 on Pastiche of Skin. Yes, we are actually continuing on our gameplay here. If you've watched all the videos in the previous part of this playlist, you've actually been watching me play through the Judgment Discs tutorial, then play through Chapter 1 and Chapter 2, and we're hammering on to Chapter 3 now, The Wide World. We saw the title line for it whenever I was shutting down the game last night, so I know what the chapter's called, but I don't know what involves itself in it, which I imagine is the opening up of the wider world where we wander around, kind of like try and raise a bit of cash, right? There's a little bit of a resistance fight back against the horrible, horrible people of Niflheim, and we fight our way back to freedom of Insomnia, and what it will inevitably be that scene that we saw at the very opening of Chapter 1, which was a lot of fire and a big, creepy, godlike creature threatening us, or not even threatening us, just nonchalantly just going, fireball to the face. Fireball to the face. So, let's see where we go from here as the plot continues on in Chapter 3. Obviously, the load times in this is ridiculous, but not much you can do about it. Like, I mean, that's running off the hard drive, so it has to just load up a lot of stuff at the very beginning. But I think that kind of gives us a baseline of where we are. We took down a outpost to the west that separated Duskay and us. Ooh, jump straight into the cutscene. Ring is the final piece. Yeah. Well, I know this guy Ravis from the Kingsglaive movie. The rest of these people, not so much. You're just going to send them after me now. Great. Yay! We're now hunted peoples. So, the crystal that they stole from the city of Insomnia, it was, in fact, it's the one thing Niflheim didn't have. Niflheim didn't have the crystal or magic to work from or to use. So, yeah, fair enough. Alright, so that's where we're going first. Yay! Hey! That's kind of cute. Alright, cool. This looks quite interesting. We did set out. We did fill the tank. Well, whatever you want to do. Yeah, screw that. Right. So, I didn't need to. I don't want to drive, but I'm. This place looks remarkably like the Hammerhead. Oh, we've got a phone call. Hi. I'm safe here now. Yeah, sounds like a plan. Our plan to take over and get back the city is going to take a while, though, Iris. So. Good grief, dude. You are thirsty. Might as well go to the Chocobo Post. I want to check it out anyway. If I just go and check it out, then that's probably fine. But if it takes me, so at least the option's there. But I'm going to take a look at Listalem. Oh, that is a cool car. I actually like the retro kind of cars. So what I was saying before these guys crudely interrupted with their conversation was that the crystals that each nation had crystals in the last one to fall was really Insomnia. And Niflheim did not have any crystals to themselves. They didn't have that power, that magic. Now they do. So they're going to obviously misappropriate it and abuse it in some way, shape, or form. Which is terrible, terrible thing to do. Don't abuse the magic, especially considering how powerful it looked whenever you saw it in Kingsglaive. Hey there. What have we got? Just the usuals. See you next time. That's great, thanks. A bugger all money. We've just got we had a couple of thousand I got from the selling of little bits and pieces. Oh, is that a poster for that thing? Yeah.
GMV update to help the heroes for grid justice.
Alright, so we're going to pop in here, see what food there is available, get our boost for the day, and then head off on the main quest line. There's the havens, there's the parking, there's the outposts, and procurement points. Yay! Okay, anytime, all times. Yeah, so if I see a Yellowtooth, I'll fight it. But I'm not going to go hunting for hunts. It's kind of like one of the things, I don't have that situation where I go and fight like 20 of a creature and then not get any value out of it. Just HP boost. Wow, that is expensive. Yeah. It's going to avoid poison because I don't want to actually get weakened down by it. Thank you very much, chap. Now you need to make treks. What? Quest is this? This is literally standing in the middle of nowhere. Yeah. Right. Hello, Sonia. First, I'm going to take your debased coin that was sitting right next to you, and then I'm going to talk to you. Ah, so this was the lady that was actually standing hanging out at the weapons truck. Oh, it's you boys. Wait, who are you again? And what do you need now? You're saying you distracted me for nothing? Oh, she's an eccentric professor, isn't she? I hear a lot of toads. Well, okay, dokie. I'm assuming frog is one of the things where I'm going to be useful to have anti-toad on me. But, yeah, you're going to find that you're going to be waiting a long damn time for that. So, what's the crack here? We'll jump in and we'll take a look at quests. And the burden of expectations. Level 10? So, are we level 10 yet? We're not even that near to level 10. All these quests I could be doing instead. So, we'll go for that one. That's our current quest. None to buy here, none to buy. So let's just jump in. The forever jump in front of the damn thing. So we'll order our way to quest location, which is that one. Happy days. So I have no qualms with actually doing these long drives and just listening to the characters interact in between. I'm sure there's actually like the quick traveling works just as well whenever you're going to run back to rest spots or run back to your car after you've gone exploring. But as it is now, I am just hammer and tonging it straight through the plot elements. What are you doing? Are you trying to put on the radio? So I'm curious about that outcropping of crystal out there. Oh, is this just seeing the wee robots or wee monsters? That'd be kind of cool. Sure. Okay, so it's kind of encouraging to actually drop little ones along the way that kind of stop us from just running off and running off and running off. So having these little instances pop up do drag me away from the main plot, but I actually like them kind of like just naturally occurring by the way I'm actually going into the game. Alright, so what are we doing? Going down here for the photo op. Photo op. Whoa. Are you serious? Alright. Ah, shit. Screw it. Oh, there we go. Stay down. Got some dead anyway. Ba-da-ba-ba-da-ba-da-ba. Yeah, Prompto. That's brilliant. This is like for him to actually make the comment as well. Like, I'm waiting for it to actually be a ringtone on somebody's phone, but that was actually even just as good. Time to strike a pose. Oh, he's even going to the bother of using a tripod. Yeah, not too sure I'm a big fan of that shot, Prompto, but we'll save it, keep it for later. So, where's the car? Oh, there's the regalia. Sprint, 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 sprint. I
I want to ride a chocobo all day until my thighs are sore and he wants to carry me no more.
Ah, damn it. Couldn't think of a lyric.
I'm on a chocobo and I'm having fun because they kind of run really, really fast.
Ah, crap. What? Damn you! Ah, shit. Mark 'em, mark 'em, mark 'em. Well, I've run out of potions. That's really disappointing. I should have actually picked up some more. Crap. Alright, I'll just pick a prompto if I need to. Bye-bye. I don't like the fact that that spawned twice. But I think one of it was actually meant to spawn whenever the car drove by. And then I actually jumped out of the car and went around another way rather than actually going the way it was. So that's probably the reason why it ended up actually being like a double encounter. But I'm still going to level up pretty well for these little random bits that are jumping in front of me. Imagine that's going to happen more and more often now that we're actually active fugitives. Let's see what else is there. So that's actually all Final Fantasy VII music. Final Fantasy 1. Oh, the battle music from Final Fantasy 1. Can't even remember it off the top of my head. Is there some people just chilling out there, was there? Let's U-turn that, because I wanted to know what the hell was actually... I don't know if that was actually a question mark because it was a parking spot and a P, or was it just because there was actually a mission there that was just random? Whoa, whoa, what the hell? Alright, it doesn't really work all that well for the controls for the car. So was there an actual mission there, or am I just imagining things? Because there's a couple of people just hanging out. I think that was just a P for parking, not a mission. Yeah, it was, it's just a parking sign. What is this? Is it? Oh, it's just the rocks. It's actually nothing else. I'm just kind of getting distracted there just by things that are around me. Alright, let's just jump back into the car. We'll not let distractions get in, because that looks like a question mark, like for a mission, rather than actually a P. My own fault. And resume. Off we go to a new place. Alright, let's see what else is actually in the soundtrack here. Thank you. Yeah, man. I actually always like the Final Fantasy opening theme. One of my favorite versions of it is actually from the end of Final Fantasy VIII, whenever it's actually played over the end credits with the additional scenes of them at the party and kind of like the everything's all right again kind of moment. So we shacks and stuff along the way here. Imagine that there's actually more missions and bits and pieces. Now, that's one of the things I'd be curious about what they were going to do with Final Fantasy 15 in the future is if they were going to put more content into this world. Because if you actually actively made almost everything in the world have some kind of small event or mission to go with it. Oh, wow. Damn. Talking about titans and the six? So I'm assuming there is six titans, six like big summon creatures. Oh man. I love these big windy roads. This is like the construction of these seem illogical, but they'd make really cool, interesting kind of views. Alright. You just go and look up there and be cool, dude. Sitting in the back of one. I honestly want just Ignis to hit the brakes and launch him off the front of the vehicle. It's a tunnel, dude. Not warping anywhere. Put it back on again just because I can. Yeah. Well, now we've got a chance to actually explore the place, don't we? Eh, there we go, parking spot and all. Fabulous. So, this place looks kind of familiar. Cool. Oh, tell me about a poster. You want to try pickled peppers? Want a pickled pepper? Pickled pepper. Hello. Hi. Oh, that's sweet. Aww. I don't know why it was actually absolutely necessary to put in the fact that the prince waves to people as he walks by. But that was kind of nice. I don't know why. Alright, so we've got to go places here. I don't know where we're meant to be or what we're meant to do, but I'm pretty sure we're just going to hit. Yeah, there we go. We've got our wee location. Cup noodles. Right, curious to find out what's going to be going on in the city, because once you get into a large populated place like this. Okay, so we're going to go meet Iris. Cool. So we need to go this way. Can we, we're going to cut it in here and go that way, because I don't want to kind of like be out in the edges of the city again still. Hello, identical twins? Yeah, girls, twinsies, that's interesting. I said I got distracted by a pair of twins. So, we're kind of running around through the city. It looks pretty, like, urban, deconstructed, decayed kind of situation going on with this. It's like, Midgar, definitely, like, under the plates of Midgar. With all these piping and kind of random bits and pieces of tech. Whoa. Yeah, so I'm connected with you, dude. I think how wild feeling that sent you. That's to summon something to come looking for you. It can see through your eyes. It knows where you are. Ha! Iris, whoa, you grew up. Huh. Oh, why did you have to, Gladiolus, why did you have to? Iris, wow. It's so weird because, like, my only experience of seeing that character is in Brotherhood as a little girl. She since she grew up to look a bit of a cross between Selphie and Tifa. Aww. Alright, you didn't drop the Your Highness stuff. Well, actually, I suppose you are the king now because your father's dead. I like her hoodie. I like the pattern on it. Fucking chaos. Yeah. That's good, but also means that Luna Freya is much closer to us than we expected, and at least now Noctis knows this. And that was day dropped. Once we got through Lys Talem. Okay. Just chilling out at the house, having a wee drink. I suppose it makes sense with the place that she's got set up. We can probably crash here instead of having to pay for it. Works pretty well. Boom. Level 13. Level 14. AP of 155. Alright. Random selfies. His leveling up photography skills are a bit weird, aren't they? And the only thing that's getting leveled up is Prompto's photography skills, because I'm rushing through these kind of sections. Ah, it's overexposed as hell, dude. That's us in the row, that's us fighting. That's him posing, that was him driving. Me waving to the random person. The only good picture there is of Iris. So, I suppose we'll save that one. Kid annoyed the hell out of me. But yeah, not really anything good otherwise. Not a brilliant action shot. Nice filter, but no. Good driving selfie, but... yeah. I think Prompt Woman needs to actually start doing more selfie-ish kind of images. I'm missing out on my level of Max Caulfield level pretentiousness in this, so we need to up that up a little bit. The next morning, obviously. Like 1 week later. Hey, Iris. Me and you, Iris. Alright. Let's get to know Iris. Alright, old man. I'm assuming the patience is referring to her. Because she wanted to walk with Noct. Okay. It's a comfortable little stroll. So, he's got a wild issue of actually, like, being close to people. He's like, no, when I'm bumming. Suppose there's collision detection for this. Whoop. Alright. Whoa, girl! Doing a bit of a sprint. Yeah, I'm a king. I can. Act interested? I actually am interested. It's all material, isn't it? Oh, right. So she's going to be the crafty person? All right, cool. Is there... All right, I'm leading the way this time, apparently. All right, fair enough. I don't know where the hell I'm going, but I'm just going to keep running. Hey, there we go. I can see a direction. Whoop. Sparkly. Good God, girl, you're a bit slow, all right? Come on, hurry up. That's kind of cool. So what is that? I guess some kind of... It's essentially some sort of ore. I can't jump up there, but... I'm trying to get a better look at it. Oh, you beat me here, then. Yeah. Interesting. Yeah. Right. So it's this way. Let's rock and roll. Ooh, climby things. Things we can climb? No, can't climb. Just one. I'm just looking out there, going like, is there a way for me to climb up that? Nope, there is not. Just for prettiness. This is rustic? It's a goddamn sprawling big city. Well, I suppose it doesn't really... It's not sprawling. It's like kind of an enclosed space, but it's still pretty damn big. Where are we going? We're going this way? Alright, cool. To the lookout! Tucking and rolling! Jumping and rolling at the speed of light. Speed of light. Jumping and rolling, jumping and rolling at the speed of light. Jumping and rolling, jumping and rolling. Oh, Iris. I make light of it. That's true. Sorry, Iris. Can't ship it. Ain't got no shipping to do, sadly. Yeah, what is this professor? Like, it seems like the professor that they've mentioned twice now, because... There was the girl that we ran into that's, like, hunting animals, and she's, like, the professor's protege. So who's the professor? Is this somebody we're going to meet? Does it? Well, that's our walk finished. Yay, plot continues. Absolute pleasure. We used to run off all the time. Yeah. Oh, cool. Well, I'm glad to keep Iris happy. She's actually a really good friend. Alright. Keep me surprised, that's alright. I'm almost sure that she bought clothing. She's going to actually make some clothing. Alright, so it's one of the tombs. Yeah, sure, why not? Sounds like a plan. Good kid. Oh, I'm not too worried, dude. Hey. We should be fine. I'm pretty sure. I think. Probably will be. We'll be alright. It's all cool. Is there actually something else? Oh, sorry, there's actually a mission in here as well, is there? It's just one of those things where it's hard to judge from the map. Let's see, we'll take a better look at it here. Zoomy, 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 zoom. Oh, you can't zoom in any more than that? Are you kidding me? That's a bit... stupid, really. Alright, let's see. We need to get to... I can take that remedy with us, of course. See, is there actually... It implies that there is a gap behind this. But I obviously can't get to it. Oh, wait, no, it's up here somewhere, is it? Right. Never mind. I'm going to take a look to see where these question marks are. See if there are actually things I can take with me on the way to grabbing the other mission besides them. Might as well log all the missions that I can in this game. And, oh, there we go. And then take the quest items if I get them back to here as I'm going back to this location. Sorry, excuse me. That might have been very, very loud for your ears. Alright. No problem, Spike. That sounds like Spike, right? Yeah. That's the mildly fucked thing in this. Look at all the identical people. One scene can't unsee. I understand like the procedural generation of non-important NPCs isn't really like a massive important thing, but that's a little bit fucked. Am I? Alright. Keep an eye out for him. Mind the trap. Yeah, sure, I'm sure we can. See what else is actually in here. Figurine modeled after the famous floral creature molded out of plaster. The statuette is heavier than its muse, but popular as a paperweight. So, what the hell would I use that for? Styling gel. A heavy-duty hair gel with unsurpassed holding power. Hairstyles retain their shape even when drenched. Oh my god. Right. So, obviously these are kind of like clothing items, but... You couldn't actually take it from the fact that it's already, like, as weird as it is, and that people are giving them shit about their character designs, that you kind of like, these bros need their hair gel. Alright, so there's one more to pick up here, and we'll continue on then after that. Yes, we do. Right. Alright, fair enough. That makes sense. Van. Obviously, it's going to probably have a creature sitting inside it or somewhere nearby, too. Either way, I have no qualms with that. No qualms with helping you out with your problem, sir. Food items! Yeah, we don't really have that much. I don't have that much money to spend on this kind of stuff as well. I'd be rather off spend on actual potions. And this is where you can buy food, is it? I might actually stop in here because Ignis might actually get a benefit out of it. Ooh. What is that? Pickled plums? That is the pickled peppers. Pick a pack of pickled peppers. Pick a pack of pickled pepper. Pick. Ignis, is that what you wanted? You wanted those? They're right there if you want them. Ooh, bounties. So, restaurateur, what do you got? Also, obviously a tipster, so get all the information that we need. Boom. That's all the bits and pieces that we need of information. Wow. Those be really, really cool if I could actually bloody afford them. Like, that equalizer as well. Damn. Right. So I need to actually really start raising money in some way, shape, or form in this. Wow, that is a lot of levels. Yeah, I'm not going to go anywhere near something that size, really, for missions at the moment. I think I'm going to have a situation here where I'm going to have to go wild onions. I'm going to have to actually go back and do a fair amount of missions whenever I've reached my limit of capability to actually get through bits without getting absolutely mauled. Which will probably happen sometime in the next episode, not in this chapter, I don't think. It doesn't look like we've actually got to the insurmountable difficulties yet. There we go. So we're going to make our way out of the city, I imagine, to head to where this waterfall is. So we probably need to get to the car. Don't we? I mean, I don't... It's about a mile that way, so if I go down here and jump into the car... Ooh, more free stuff. Alright, we need to get to the parking spot. There it is. Jump and roll, jump and roll. We're a little faster when we jump and roll, jump and roll. Right, into the regalia, hit auto, quest location, and we go for the sword in the waterfall. Boom. Problem solved. So we're probably going to use the car as a shop to pick up some items as well. Oh, damn. Wait, hang on. Whoa, whoa. Need to jump out here. I saw a quest question mark behind us here. Exactly. It's up to me. Do whatever I tell you to. Mush, mush. There we go. Hello there. You're obviously not like... One of these things are not like the others. One of these things are just like me with fire hair. Hmm. Oh yeah, famous hunters. Well, I do actually need cash. Yeah. All right. Right. That was actually oddly specific, kind of like side story event, but interesting. Oh, that looks cool. Ah, I want to actually take a better look. I want a first-person perspective, but that looks actually pretty awesome. I like the way that just glows in the night. Damn. Well, imagine there is a catch. So, obviously it's getting to dark, so we may need to crash out for the night. That's going to be interesting. Is there somewhere for me to sleep is a better question. Oh, that wasn't what I meant to do. Crap. Yeah, what is up with your headaches, dude? I can't jump on cars. So, I'm just looking here to see if I can spot where I need to go. I'm not seeing much progress or help. Oh, is that a... Oh, cup of noodles. Excuse me. Cup of noodles. That's useful. I wouldn't mind. What does it do? Oh, shit, yeah. That's actually not too bad. I might actually buy two of those. So if I'm going to grab a stop anywhere, it might actually be helpful to grab a bite of that. Plus, Ignis knows how to make them if I have the ingredients now. So, I'm actually at the situation now where it's too late to drive. So I need to find somewhere to stay. Is there somewhere to stay? That's a gas station that's... Oh! I was going to waste a little bit of time here and actually grab the items that I need. Yeah? There we go. So I've got one in stock now because I actually bought one or I found one. But I'm going to grab another 9. Two of those. Don't know if I... I'm all out of Phoenix Downs as well. So I can't afford to lose if I'm going to die. That's not good. Repair kit? Hmm. Oh, there's Final Fantasy 14, Disc 1 and 2. Awesome. Oh, man. That'd be really cool. So much music and so much stuff. So, I mean, essentially the item prices in this feel like I really should be doing a lot more missions than I actually am so far. That's what it implies to me. Fuel efficiency. Yeah. I really should be doing more missions, but I'm going to see how far I can get without doing any of them. Like that's what this challenge is. This is actually the minimum money, no extra mission challenge for Final Fantasy 15. Unnecessarily. Essentially, it's the same as the Lazy Bastard challenge, where you just happen to do what I like, do the bare minimal for what you need to actually do. Alright, I need to go and crash somewhere, so I think I might need to go back to where we were previously. Until my chaps get sore, and I can't take it anymore. Dead end. Huh. Well, my wanderings actually managed to find something. Beautiful bottle. Oh, you can use a bottle for that. Yeah, that's, I'm just wasting time now. I'm just trying to find where I need to rest. Okay, do you know what, actually, if I use the map, return to rest point, and lodgings, yep, there we go, bam, sorted. I was running around there and actually going like, why am I running around?
The Ring of the Lucii, harboring the souls of Lucian kings.
So, yeah. That's me here now. Do I have to pay now? God damn it. So now I have to stay up all night. Unless I can find money.
Oh. The Covenant. The earliest accounts of the Covenants were found in ancient tombs dating back to the time of cosmogony, some 2 millennia ago. According to such tombs, the rites are a means by which the oracle summoned forth the gods that she might have the force of the will of mortals known unto the divine.
Okay, so essentially that's what the oracle does. The oracle actually summons creatures and shit. That's kind of impressive. Hey! Just standing and sell shit up. Yeah, smelling salts and maiden's kiss. Nice. So, if I jump over here to treasures, and I can sell some stuff. I've got something I've got 10 of. Yeah, there we go. Anything I've got, like, multiples of, and they're worthwhile. There we go, just grab and sell one of those. Yeah. So I managed to get 1,000 out of that. So that's the bare minimals that I have. Essentially, all I've got is the little bits of crap that I've actually picked up from guys. Because, I mean, you don't get money in this from monster fights. You just get crafting materials, which you then can sell. So imagine that's what I'm meant to be doing with that if I'm not building stuff constantly. And I'm not really focusing on that kind of stuff in this playthrough. I'll think about it more as I go along, but as it is now, it's just like the default whatever I have in my hand. So what did I do today? Bugger all. Only knocked us got EXP as well. Suppose it makes sense because he was actually the one on the walk with the girl. Yeah, we did nothing. Aww. That was actually sounded like a very upset brother, kind of like, Iris, get off the bed with that boy. Hey, what are you all worried about, man? Yeah, good grin on you there. Us getting turned away from the counter at that time of night. Really good choice, Prompto. You're a nice guy. Thanks for making me feel great about that. I've got a wild feeling that all these photographs all at the very end become like a photo book kind of like history. If you didn't see one from each event, then, or one from each day, that you wouldn't have actually, like, you'll probably end up not having anything to show. Alright, let's see here. Now we need to get our ass into the car. Come on. Let's rock and roll. Get in the car. Get in the fucking car. We need to get in the car. Safety of walls. It's kind of useful to actually be able to believe that we're not going to have something swoop down on us in the middle of the night, you know? Alright, so resuming, we're going back the same path we're going. Back up at 6 a.m. on the road. Let's rock and roll, guys. Let's go and find some... Let's go and find ourselves a mystical tomb or cave or something or other. Look at that beautiful skip. What the hell? Nothing really, Ignis, me, Gladio. Well, yeah, actually, take more shots of Ignis. Alright, so all the events today means that... Alright, that's cool. That's... Okay, so it makes sense of actually, like, what selfie's going to be taken if you actually kind of mark somebody for, like... Alright, more of Gladios. More of Ignis. So I'm using Ignis's marking ability. That looks like... That mark ability is pretty... Not massively powerful, but it's really, really useful because it hits multiple opponents with me striking between them, which is essentially what I'm doing anyway because I'm always teleporting out, swinging in, and then attacking, and then teleporting out and swinging in and attack. Oh, I was wondering there, I was going like... Are we just, like, Looney Tuned ourselves into, like, a black hole? Did the radio stop because we went under a tunnel? Oh, alright, sorry, it's just randomly picking ones. Music from Justice Monster 5 as well. I thought it was just the Final Fantasies were actually in the soundtrack. Nah, Justice Monster 5 is in there too. Alright. Oh, we're actually about half tank. Should have thought that through because I really don't want to be pushing this car back to the city. Yeah. Wow, we're really in the shadow of that now, aren't we? So I can see what Fraser was talking about, Frash was talking about in his Let's Play about the level of detail being oddly flat in a lot of places. But this isn't an ugly game by any stretch of imagination, and the locations seem to be well scaled. Is this where we need to be? Alright. Well, we do need to refuel anyway, so we'll just spend the gil, fill the tank. Oh, that's right. Cindy did the refueling whenever we're at the other station, and so she did the whole thing. Let's polish your knob. In this case, it was Noctis just looking at it. So, is there anything to see here? That's the question. There's a place I can break stop. There's, of course, a shop here as well. Let's see if they got anything interesting. Like, if they got a soundtrack that's on that I want, I probably will grab it. Look at that big bass holding motherfucker. 4 foot Lucian sea bass? A myth no more. Cheesy chips. Prompt is very conscious about his weight because of, like, being a fat kid. It's kind of sad that he actually... Oh, wow, Jesus. 5 discs of Final Fantasy XI. Set in the Royal Stripe decal series. Stick this on your car to give it a look of luxury. Ooh, yeah. So these are all fishing lures and stuff. And what's the last thing? Iron Shelf Recipes Volume 3? Huh. Oh, so you can buy stuff here as well? Huh. So that's if you actually just didn't want to go bother hunting for particular items to actually repair stuff or work on stuff, then you can do that instead. I don't want to grab anything from the 11 soundtrack. If there was been 8, 9, or... Well, actually, I should go back and get those 14 ones, but I don't want to spend money on them that I don't need. Should have enough stuff now. I don't have 1,000 to spend on a... Yolder Giveaway, the first nest for all hatchlings 12 and under while supplies last. Aw, that's cute. Those little hatchlings. A few Q-chips. Oil. Nothing else of import. Let's see. We need to go and do our mission. What? It's still like 20 feet. You want us to do it on foot? Okay, right. I'm going to go and do it on foot. Because no matter what, I can teleport back to the car. And now I can get to the rest spot if it gets too dark. So that's probably the better idea. Yeah. 2,900 feet away. That road does not drop down anytime soon. So this is probably our best bet to get down there anyway. Run to the waterfall, run to the waterfall, run to the waterfall, that's where we go. Okay, I'm assuming I need to get underneath this at some point, so I'm assuming this will turn right. Ooh. Ah, high potions. Sweet. Somebody just dropping stuff on the trail. We're picking up their trash and we're keeping it for ourselves. So I need to be over there. Why am I not turning around the corner? Whoa! Should I? Do I still have my poison protection? Probably sure I don't. No, I don't have it anymore. Shit. Oh, man. That looks cool, though. Oh. Yeah. Oh, shit! Oh, shit! No, that was not good. Oh, man. This is not a good move. Alright, we need to get out of here. Because we are super poisoned. Wow. That was all sorts of horrible idea. That was a terrible idea. Why did I even think that? Oh man, I'm going to get poisoned into crap. Oh, that sucks. Oh. Yeah, I don't want to fight that thing, but I want to get around to the other side of the goddamn waterfall. Is there a way around? It's that fucking thing is actually, like, blocking the way. Son of a bitch. Okay, so this is an example of, like, why I shouldn't have skipped ahead, I suppose. Let's jump across here. Well, that was useful. Thank you. Right, so this is obviously I am getting my ass stomped now because I just don't have the ability that I need. Oh, shit! Oh no! Whoa! Yeah, I'm with you. Wow, I am getting my ass beat by these guys. Wow.
After that life-threatening battle where we were almost dead, we didn't know what to do. But now we know.
Alright, so we got plenty of turmeric and we got those claws. So, wow. That's a perfect example of this area, what I'm meant to be doing now, this mission, maybe around about area level 18. I am obviously under-equipped because I am level 15 and not got much weapons. Do you want to really help? Probably using the Ascension Grid that I've completely ignored until now. But 160 points to using it. Yeah, that might be damn useful. Let's get some of the really low-level basic stuff covered out of the way. I don't need that. And that might be useful. So, techniques... That's 48 required for that. That's a possibility that distracts them. Depletes the bar by 2? Wow. Oh yeah, no, we need that one. Instantly heals the party? So what else we got here? Boost an ally's defense after taking them out of danger. Increase HP recovery rate while hanging after warp point. Yeah. While in cover. Well, that's actually kind of useful. I do need to take a lot of these recovery skills because I notice I'm actually taking a lot of damage actually. Recover a bit of HP with a first aid kit when HP is low. What magic have we got here? Absorb more energy. Enhance potency by 10 when crafting spells. Yeah. Wait mode? Do I use wait mode? The likelihood of it breaking its appendage? Nice. Right. Oh, so what's this? This is actually the AP I was getting from just chilling out with my guys. That's all stats effect added from being in vehicles. HP increase anyway, so that's generally going to be helpful. I haven't used that at all. Those are all going to be really useful whenever I have massive amounts of AP. It's a boosted damage in those link strikes and stuff, but I don't really have anything that'll make an enemy flinch with a paralyzing kick. That's pretty useful. I've got, what, 123 left, so I need to actually still clear out all these like low-level ones. Experi magic. Increase Nox MP by the number of levels he has gained. Effects are similar. Abilities do not stack. Yeah. Ultra light. Further reduce MP of phasing. Yeah. MP essentially is how many times I can do that warp strike, really. So it's either that or that. But I mean, I'll be more likely to take that over anything else because I warp strike constantly. Oh, that's useful. No matter what, whenever I hit things, it'll increase the bar. Star shell to distract. That sounds useful. Ooh, big heavy strike. So what's in here? Enhancement? Or allied attacks on a foe with a devastating death boost strikes depletes tech. That's actually just kind of like makes everybody attack one person, I suppose. Yeah, that's going to be too useful to have. And regen is actually an important thing to have, I suppose, in general. So I'll take a look to see what ones come with it. First aid kit. So it's telling each one of them that they'll actually heal if they have a first aid kit. I've got 57 left, so what are we going to use it on? Magic crafting. I don't really see myself using that much magic so far in this. I don't see myself doing it more often. But, I suppose. If anything, the potency is probably the more important one to take. Because I'm not going to use it that often, but whatever I do make needs to be strong. So, what was the thing that actually thought was going to be used by Ignis to scan? Is that in here, is it? There we go. So, that's there. Ignis, analyze, automatically scan most enemies' weaknesses at the event onset of battle. Know how to spend ability points. So I've got 18 left, so I might just drop it into pure combat skills so I can do things better. I mean, there's 6 points on that airstrike. It's really, really cheap to grab in midair by holding square. Ooh, strike down from above. Death drop. We've only got 31 left. Recover, so it doesn't cost me anything on that one. It recovers it if I actually use it then with that. That's cool. Oh yeah, that's what I need. I need to boost my warp strike. Okay, so I've got, what, 7 left? I don't have enough to actually... I was going to go and grab that Dawnhammer thing for one of these characters here, but... Nah. That's good and grand. So that should be me kind of like a little bit leveled up. At least that's HP covered anyway. Do a little bit of elemency. We do have a plenty of magic, actually. That's kind of cool. We've got plenty of bottles to work with. So we'll do some of that. That's cool. So by using 1, I automatically have 10. Alright, so if I have Blizzard there and give it a, 20 potency and bring it into craft, that means I have 3 of those. Happy days. Equip, actually. Put you in there. And, oh yes, I can do magic for everybody. So, I've got fire. I might as well give somebody some of that. Bam. Equip. No. Store. Egypt. Give you thunder. You've already got Drain Lance. Ooh, spare stuff here that I haven't actually put into people either yet. HP recovery rate. Yep, definitely taking that one. I think you need the extra bit of HP I suppose you actually need it better than that. You have the lowest HP and you obviously kind of get into that situation a bit more often than I do. Yeah, you've got secondary arms already, so you're pretty much the only one who's going to have a weapon... Garnet Bracelet. What does Garnet Bracelet do? Enhances strength. Right. Well, I am probably going to go with that. I'm going to give you the Garnet Bracelet. And you're going to be taking either maximum HP or Spirit. I don't think you need it as much, so I think I'll give you Spirit anyway. Bam. Done and dusted. Oh, right, you can give them different... that's annoying, so I lose marked if I take regroup. Right. Interesting. Piercer, a firearm to hit multiple enemies in a line, reduces enemy defense. Oh, right. So it finds enemies and hits them multiple in the line. Okay. So I'm going to keep Mark for the moment because I actually like the fact that it says multiple strikes. Although I do like his, like the use of regroup's going to be. I'm not going to use regroup just yet. I don't think I'm going to need it. Right. So that's me sorted for. Oh, sorry, dude. Didn't mean to do none, but all I was doing was just like picking up my weapons. So I need to get. How do I get the waterfall from here? Motherfuck! Alright, so I need to go up along this way. If not, there's even like a treasure box here somewhere, isn't there? What is that? Oh, damn. Treasure down there? Yeah! Oh, Mega Phoenix? That's going to actually be damn useful. Damn it. It would help if I could actually just teleport up, but no, not going to let me. Is there another item there? Oh, no, it's just the waypoint icon to get me back to where I needed to be. Yeah, let's look behind the waterfall. Let me guess, there's going to be a giant motherfucker right there. Okay, let's take a look. Oh, this is a nice Kiev. Yeah, I'm just going to change my magic to make sure that I've got fire on me. I just want to equip. All right, gear. Imagine it's actually in. Noctis, Blizzard, switching out for... Whoa, what's that? Machinery? Oh, cool. Fire. Axe of the Conqueror? Wow, that is fucking heavy. I'm just looking at the attack strength of those things. Bam. Alright, so magic grabbed. That is, of course, something that's going to go into his. So auto 61, that one's 90, is it? Yeah. Reduces bolt strength. Well, it does increase his attack and damage, but reduces health as well. That's great. We're going to go with the most powerful thing I can give him. Is there anything else for him? No. Masamune, like, nothing's really as powerful as the Masamune that I got from Chrono Trigger anyway, so... Happy days! Right, now we're ready to actually go into the Kiev. Whoa! So, ran into some flans there then? Motherfuck. That was a bit terrifying. Oh, that's going to be slidey. Yeah, I'm not getting back up from there if I actually go down that way. What is this? I mean, there's actually obviously another tunnel up here, but I can't get to it. Alright, so I imagine that's probably going to be the way I come back around after going down this way. So, have fun! Oi, oi, oi. That was no fun. So, a bunch of imps. That was interesting. Huh. That perturbed me a little bit. So, yeah. Let's keep on exploring this, Kiev. Eh. Yeah, rusted bit. Fantastic. Wait, what? Is this going to send me further into the cave?
Ah!
Here we go again! Oh, god damn it! Right. That was interesting. Oh, I like the fact that the circular saw looked kind of cool. The kind of spinny weapon that he had. I obviously have no idea where I'm going inside this map. I'm just kind of like wandering, which is not a good combination. Let's get ourselves magged up anyway. Yeah, that's great. Glad to have that full. Could absorb more. But we probably can't, so I'm just going to go and use my elemency and go and just fill out a full batch of that.
Boom!
Got a full-on batch of, like, ridiculous Blazara. We'll store that for now, because we've been using fire. And we can take the rest of that. So... we want to go this way. Imagine this is where we need to go. Ooh, is there... oh, shit! Oh, crap. Ugh! Yeah, mark 'em. I don't know where the hell I'm actually meant to be attacking these guys. Because I seem to be bouncing around them rather than actually attacking them. Right, so I wasn't meant to jump down here because there's no way for me to get back up, is there? Yep, there's no way for me to get back up from here. Thought it would actually be one of those things where I could just climb my way up, but of course, because it's ice ground, it makes it impossible. God damn it. Ignis is the one that's down to no health? That's fucked up, man. He's so close to actually dying. Yeah, I'm not massively liking what's going on here. Assuming if I keep down here, I'm going to keep running into imps. Is there a reason for me to stay down here? No. Star pendant. That's kind of cool. What the fuck? Oh, I thought that was actually a tunnel. Star pendant. What does star pendant do? Oh, poison safety. That's useful. I might actually use that whenever we get back outside again. Okay, so we're getting closer to where we need to be, one hopes. I don't like the fact that my guys are so down in health. I mean, if I can't recover health back like this, can I? Stores maximum HP and MP. See, I've gotten beaten down so many times that I don't think I can actually, yeah. So that's the problem whenever you actually start losing health like that. White choker. Assume that one's actually to do with safety from ice. That might be really useful. Oh, no. Yeah, well, that's actually slightly better. So at least I'm on the right side, am I? No? No, it's not even around this way. How do I get across to there? That's where I need to be. Oh, hang on. Alright. So I need to actually go up along this edge and crawl across. Hey. Yeah, I'm going. Oh, why you got to pick the creepy angle? That's me across anyway. Obviously there's going to be enemies right around this corner. It's got to be. Ooh, there's fire. Could be useful. Oh, yeah. Well, let's make use of that.
Element C.
Alright. That's... Is it 9 or 90? I can't even tell. Sorry, I've got a camera issue of something in my way. Oh, there we go. Yeah, I can see it now. I'm just checking my screen. That should be fine. I'm going to make more if we need it. I'm not going to toss magic for no apparent reason. But I'll keep that inventory full for now. So, where are we going next? We need to get over there. So, imagine we're going this way. Boom! That was gratifying. This is where we need to go, right? Is he running around complaining about the goddamn cold? Is he looking at them? Damn kid. Oh! Was that another button press kind of thing so I could actually have gotten more? Ah, that makes more sense now. So where are we going? We need to continue on this way. Ooh. I really don't want to fall down any of these platforms again. Oh, God damn it. come on! What the fuck was that? Who's that? Whoa, I have no idea who the hell that is. What is that? Ronan? Who the fuck's Ronan? Oh man, I am getting my ass beat. Yeah, I have no idea what was going on there. So, Noctis, we need you to, yeah, I've got an idea. I'm going to grab that. Going to go into Noctis. Going to grab this. Going to go and grab a spell. I'm grabbing the Blazaras. And I am fucking wrecking your shit. This is fucking me all up. What the fuck were you, Ronan? Oh, man. That was not the guy I was expecting to be running into for a fight here. That was, caught me off guard a little bit. So I'm assuming this isn't the route I'm meant to be taking. I'm meant to be going some other way to get to this guy. Because that seemed to be, like, unnecessary boss fight level kind of combat. Whoa, how the hell did you get over there, Prompto? Little shit. I'm assuming I've got one of these ledges to walk along. But yeah, that Ronan dude was wrecking my shit there, man. I didn't even know he was there. I thought it was just another couple of flans until he actually like wrecked everybody, and I was like, why is everybody going down to like three flans? And I spotted him fighting in that same area. The camera is a massive issue in combat like that, because I did not know what that dude was. I need to learn how to use the wit mode. I haven't used wit mode yet to play this. I've been all active combat, so maybe I'm just poorly implementing the battle system in this. Well, that's obviously the way we're meant to go, but what is in here? Oh, this is the way back. Okay, I get you. Boom. Equip. In there. Fira. I'm getting my ass beat again. Yep. Target them up for me. Bam, 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 bam. Bam! Ah, missed that one. Oh, shit. Potion me. And I'm going to switch over skills. I need to go to Ignis and take his move off Mark, put it on regroup. Oh man, that's fucked. Ah! Why am I running in one? Oh man, my controls are completely screwed. I don't know what's up. I'm stuck facing one direction. I can't look in another way. Why? Oh, God damn it. Don't have any Phoenix Downs to drop on them, so I'm kind of half screwed until the rest of the team go down. I'm not going to drop one on that intentionally. I just realized that there's a goddamn fucking warp point sitting right there I could have been using. Oh, come on, you serious? Oh, come on! Are you fucking serious? Ah, oh, man. Have I got confusion on me? Is that what it is? Come on! Fuck off! It's fucking every single time it says he kills me. Ah, come on! Every fucking time! shit. Yeah, that was unbelievably close so many times there. Whoo! Right. So I'm definitely not massively overpowered for combat in this. Every time they grabbed me for that, it was wrecking my ass, man. That was really, really fucking irritating. Ooh. So those mind flayers, they were fucked up. Like, they were causing confusion, which was making me lose control of my character. If I scored that fireball at the very beginning, I might have taken out two of them, and that would have made it so much easier. I just dumped items there. That was just item spamming is the only way I managed to survive that all at all. Plus, switching across to having regroup, that regroup is unbelievably useful. Wow. That was rough. That was super rough. Now this can conjure the armiger. It's an arsenal of royal arms. When the circular armiger bar is full, the bar fills as Noctis attacks and defends, and all his abilities are strengthened while the royal arms are active. So, L1, R1. So now I have enough of those. I essentially have an ultimate for Noctis. Nexus has been added to the astral sphere. That's a nexus for that. Spend AP to power up your arsenal of royal arms. Right. Cool. Awesome. So I've got that unlocked now. Oh, man. Return to the entrance. Yes, fucking please. Let's get this shit out of here. Back to somewhere safe. Restock. Maybe complete doing a bunch of side missions. Ooh, what's up? Right. I saw visions. Quite likely. You need to go there anyway for the photographs, so. Two birds, one stone. Our asses have been completely wrecked here. I'm tempted to actually just quick teleport back because I'm afraid of actually running into anything down here. I can see shit moving down there. I don't like it. Is there any way I can get up there quick? No. Ugh. Right. I think we need to actually go back to the rest point quickly to get on to the next part. What the hell? I thought I saw someone moving at the bottom there. So quests, The Way of Gods and Kings. Okay. So we can go and do that one, but we'll get out of the way of this stuff first. So map, easy enough to do. Return to rest point. No, that's be there. Return to the car. We get back to the car, we can actually jump in to a Winnebago that's right next to it, and that'll actually allow us to rest and gather our stuff, and then we can probably do a wander back and see if there's any extra stuff that we want. That wrecked me for items. Like, that's all my Mega Phoenixes that I found are gone. They were unbelievably useful, but I don't think I should have been using them to make it through a fight like that. But I mean, shit, that's what they're there for. I imagine you can buy Mega Phoenixes, hopefully, because they seem to be treasures. I don't want to have that be the case. So one day elapsed, and we're in a souvenir emporium. Right, fair enough. What did we unlock today? That was a pretty decent EXP gain, though, about 5,000. Boom. We're still not even the level. Like, Noctis is the only one who's the level of the Ronin that we fought earlier on. Oh, Jesus. Level 3. Survival, yeah, you were a survivor in that match, man. That was actually a pretty nice shot. Ignis chilling in the car. Ignis and Noctis. Yeah, I like that one. Oh, That's actually a pretty decent one. Is that against the Ronin as well? Frozen Ronin? Nice. Yeah, I don't know what that one was. That's like just dodging one of those guys. I do like that one. I do like these little kind of like half running shots. No idea what that was meant to be. But yeah, I do like that one of the Frozen Ronin because he was like mid-strike as well. Fuck you, guy. So that's us well rested. I suppose our next stop is to head on to the plates, but I don't have that. I don't really have the items for it. I don't really have the the setup for it. So let's see. Maybe if this guy has enough kind of potions and stuff that I can buy. I'm only got about 600 for this. All right, let's jump into that. So that's how much is that? That's what 500 already. I do need the 10 of them, like, because I burned through those pretty damn quickly. I have no money for Phoenix Downs. At least I still have enough left if I want to stay in a Winnebago again for a night. Winnebago, Winnebago. Right, let's see what we got here. We're going to the quest location, and we're going to drive all the way there. That's actually the one for the birds, isn't it? Does that show, is that like fast forward and actually showing like I could quick travel there, or is that actually just for any particular other reason? Let's go that way anyway. No, fast travel to destination? No, fuck that. So you can spend money to fast travel. I don't have the money to pay for fast travel, so we're going to be taking the long road. Long driving, chilling, just sitting here hanging out with my bros, you know. Man, that was vicious in that last cave. Now, the Ronin, that caught me off guard. He was obviously, like, kind of the midway boss for going in. But then those mind flayers afterwards. Like, I mean, they probably weren't that big of a deal. It's just I really messed it up by using the Blizzard magic and then having to wait for the reload. And if I had got him, if I got the imps and them at the very beginning with the big heavy fire damage, like one single ball in the center of them, that would have been really, really useful. So yeah, the mind flayer did his job reasonably well, flaying my mind there because I was in sheer panic. I like this kind of like start to finish marking for it, so we know how far we already are in the journey. Part and parcel of this being as constructed as this, pronto. I want to see his hair actually being more buffeted in the wind, considering the fact they're going about, what, 50, 60 with him standing up in the car. I'd be curious to know what the history is in character, about, like, why the reason why the Mind Flayers were there. I think monsters and mutations just being in different places seems to be all that's actually kind of like, it's just these things are here. That Ronin, I have no idea why it was the only one of its kind inside that dungeon. Definitely wasn't a random spawn. I don't think it was by any stretch of imagination, but it would have been weird. Oh, so whenever you actually pass by parking spots, if you hit hop off, it'll actually let you out right there. I think that's what the intention of it is. Almost there. Almost there. Almost there. Yeah. So we're actually working our way towards that disc, wasn't it? They called it the disc of damage, wherever the meteor hit. I'm sure I'm almost there. Ah, well, 3/4 of the way. So with the visions that Noctis is getting, I'm assuming these are either because of Luna Freya or because he's also an oracle in some way, shape, or form, because we're kind of implying that connectivity to the six titans through something like that. But I don't know how that's going to imply. We have literally driven straight to the power stations, kind of like output plant, haven't we? Oh no, this is town? Alright, we're driven back into town. Wow, that car's refueled. Did we buy fuel? Oh, we did buy fuel just before we left the last time. So, yeah. We're back in Listalum. This is the fact that we do have to wait for their parking. Ignis is a good parker. I mean, he parked the car in shade the last time we went to a place. That's considerate driving. I mean, admittedly, that's the parking spot over there, dude. I mean, your precision's a little bit off, but that's fine. Right, we go up this way, do we? Well, we go this way anyway. Jumping and rolling at the speed of Knuckles, what the fuck is going on? Jumping around at the speed of Knuckles, what the fuck is going on? Yeah. Let's make it. Come on, there we go. We got there. Keep moving. So we returned back to the original house that we were in. We're back to see the people that we wanted to see. Let's, imagine they're probably going to have a discussion about what's going on inside of Noctis's head. I'm sure somebody here, especially the old man, will already know what it's about. Well, well, indeed. Well met. Okay, straight into another one. Whoa! That was mildly perturbing. Right. Apparently looking through a couple of like wee blinker window things is going to actually help us know what the fuck's going on. Alright. Whatever you think, guys. Whatever you think. No, can't jump over that one. Slidey, roly, roly, slidey. Did you just, like, did we just walk past a woman and discover her meal? Alright. Oh, whatever. Oh, you! Huh. What? Right. I don't trust you as far as I can throw you. Who are you? I don't trust this dude at all. But I wanted to use this thing. Right. I don't trust following your ass, man. You perturb me. You're intentionally perturbing. Which one's your car? Oh, please be the green beetle. Please. Hello? Alright, you had to go muscle car. Huh. Can't jump on top of it. Damn it. So what do you want me to do? Do you want me to follow you? Get into this one? Okay. Alright, so I'm coming with you then. Yeah, we might as well. Let us rock and roll. I'm going to ride with Arden. I want to know what this guy's about. Am I going to have to drive the car? Screw that, man. I wasn't intending on driving at any point in this game. That was Ignis's gig. Okay, so that's the end of the chapter. Yeah, so obviously we're going to head on to this next location fairly shortly. So, I'm lucky I made it through that battle at all. I'm really, really on like the skin of my teeth, equipment, money, and all that crack-wise. Maybe this is not a smart move, but I'm going to keep on just pushing through these story missions and see if I get to the point where I'm just completely destroyed by them. And I'm sure there'll be a save, an auto-save to pick me up along the way. So, yeah. Guys, thank you very much for watching. This has been Chapter 3 of Final Fantasy 15. The more will continue throughout the weeks and throughout the time of this game being in my hands. I want to play through it as fast as possible to get to see the story elements as fast as I can. And I'm sure you guys are probably watching all the other stuff on other people's channels. But thank you very much for choosing to watch mine. I hope you've had a great good time. And I will see you all very soon for the next episode. Of course, if you liked what you saw, there's a subscribe button sitting up there that you can hit. That'll actually allow you to see everything that comes up on this channel as it comes out. And if you check over on this side over here, there's actually playlists for videos that I've been doing over the last couple of weeks on the station and on this channel. So you can, of course, check those out there. So again, thank you very much for watching. And I will see you all in the next episode. Bye.